I work in the compliance arena as a director of a company on the Isle of Man, and we provide outsourcing of compliance. And I've found the qualifications very useful in a practical sense over the years, and I'd highly recommend them to anyone in the industry.
I've always been aware of what the compliance needs are, and that always made me wonder whether I would do well, and it always fascinated me. And that's the reason that I want to move into compliance, because I think it is the next in thing. And as I have rightly learned in my compliance course as well, that as a compliance officer, you're not just a watchdog of the organization, you're actually working with the organization to give them and take them to the heights that the organization needs to work for. Also at the same time, doing the best for the customers, which is the next big thing.
I'd looked at the ICA a few years ago, and at that time, commitment wasn't good enough. I didn't have the time to commit to it. Working in London, you spend more time commuting than you do actually working. So moving out, the time frames were better for me. It gave me the time to study. It is a commitment, but it's a very worthwhile commitment. And it's certainly already given me more weight in my organization. I'm the specialist compliance person at the company, and they've started listening to me even now, even more in the last few weeks after passing, so it's been well worth it.
It just brings you so much at par with what you are doing on a day-to-day basis, A lot of times, it has helped me actually to develop a macro view of what compliance within a financial services firm should be like. When you do just compliance monitoring, you are really clueless about what other areas of compliance actually are, in terms of advisory, in terms of guidance, in terms of training, in terms of, providing day-to-day business support and partnership. This course has actually helped me to build a macro view and apply the basic principles. And it's not only do I feel, but my peers and my superiors feel that, it's actually made that tad bit of difference in the way I work, in the way I draft my reports now, in the way I try to be very lucid in the communications, and I try and be very, very influencing on business, at the same time being very approachable, for the business. So it's definitely added a lot of value to me.
Having finished the three diplomas and the graduate diploma, I'm hoping to start the master's in July, I believe it is, this year, in law, governance, risk and compliance. So I think that's a logical next step, and it's fantastic that they've partnered up with the University of Law to provide a master's qualification. So I'm really looking forward to that.
It was actually my husband, he works for a bank as well, and when I was discussing with him that I really think compliance is the way to go and I want to have a career in it, he said, if you want to do it, why don't you just start with ICA, because that is something which in his bank everybody recommends. Also the people who are in compliance have been asked to go and take a diploma from ICA, and I thought this was the right way for me to go, and I would definitely recommend it to anyone, because the kind of knowledge I've gained here, the insight and the know-how, I think for me to move from sales into compliance, ICA is the way to go, honestly.
It's an absolutely must for not only aspiring compliance professionals, but also people who've been in the industry. It gives you a totally different perspective. It enables you, one, because of the widespread reading that it allows you to do, it enables you to read much wider and much farther than what you normally do on a day-to-day basis, and then apply that in your role and take it to a different level. It's not only good for compliance, but also for the business and for the bank that you represent or the financial services firm that you represent. Because eventually you are there to work in partnership and let the revenue scores go higher, but at the same time limit the regulatory fines. So you're kind of, acting as a fine balance between the two of them. Definitely a must do. I myself intend to undertake my next diploma, which would be in anti-money laundering. And hopefully, if all goes well, I should do a postgraduate and become a fellow for the Institute as well.
This for compliance is the true statement. It is the qualification.